Hello, Skullgirls fans. This is Shadow Fury 63 with a, well, my regular quick match thing. But this is a bit special because this weekend, Skullgirls is free. Everyone can play it for free this weekend. So I figure I might as well just do a stream on that and maybe go over small things that might be relevant to new players. But for the most part, this is just my normal stream, just pointing out that, well, you can get it on Steam this week for free, and also it's 80% off if you want to buy it. It's like 10 bucks the entire thing. I am overplaying beta because I was playing the regular version the other day, and I felt kind of bad because there was a lot of players who were clearly new, and I didn't want to just completely ruin their experience because, well, this is a game that can be really oppressive if one player knows how to play and the other doesn't. And granted, I don't know how to play very well, but it's still the fact that compared to the players I was playing in retail, I'm never gonna combo properly. Compared to the players I was playing in retail, although this is actually a bit of an exception as well because this is going extremely well for me. But yeah, it was like every single match I was playing in retail was, I could tell they had just picked up the game, like they had just bought it in the sale, and I felt kind of bad. I didn't want to completely body everybody I encountered. So I play in beta, because that seems like it's more likely to have veterans playing it. Also, because then I can do the silly announcer and silly voices if people want to use them. Because the voice packs and announcer packs, other than the Soviet announcer, are all in beta. As is RoboFortune, who will be in retail eventually. If you buy retail now, RoboFortune will be free, by the way. As is Beowulf right now, though admittedly, like I said, it's 10 bucks for the entire game and all the DLC that's released so far. And I'm pretty sure that means forever. Although if they do release a second Encore Challenge content onto PC, then that will be paid. But otherwise, yeah, free! Yay! Everyone likes free. And speaking of RoboFortune, RoboFortune!
Who will be my right home?
Great. Stupid funny announcer. Ah. Okay, yeah, I'm not too used to playing RoboFortune. She has a lot of full screen specials. Darn it, I'm never gonna get that right. It's heavy punch, air dash, heavy punch. It shouldn't be that hard, but it's, for some bizarre reason, I found it extremely difficult to do properly. Oops. That was a hit confirm opportunity. RoboFortune is scary. I am not used to fighting RoboFortune, so excuse my terrible performance right now. Well, at least that's something. Would prefer to have DHC'd, but meh. Darn it. Ow. Pretty hard knockdowns. There are very few of them in this game, but when they happen, it's extremely annoying. What the? Oh, that's an overhead. How am I not used to Big Band? I spent so much time practicing against a Big Band when I first started playing. It's like, you'd think I'd know. When I first started really learning how to play the game. Ow! Yeah, that's always a bad idea to take one's head off against Big Band, but I needed that combo to continue. Oh well. Alright, well, like I said, I'm playing this one because I figured there'll be players who know what they're doing. I won't feel like I'm just wrecking players' days who just picked up this game and suddenly someone is randomly just wiping them out completely and they have no chance whatsoever. Although that's one thing about this game is that until you really learn how to block properly, it can feel like that because there really isn't a way to get out of anything. It's one thing I gotta credit to Arxis in general, is that their games, I mean, there's a lot of things you can credit Arxis, but Arxis is really good about making it not feel so oppressive, because there are ways of getting out when you've gotten hit. And other than BlazBlue, the combos are typically not particularly long. For P4A, they can be sort of long. Guilty Gear, they're generally not that long. But you can burst out of them. So even if you get hit, you have ways out of it. So if you're not very good, it still feels like you have something to work with. Skullgirls, on the other hand, if you're not blocking, which that was a bad case of me pressing buttons, but yeah, if you're blocking, there's a lot of options. If you're not blocking, then you don't have so many options. Like, push blocking is a huge deal, but if you're not blocking, if you're getting hit, you're basically watching a movie, as I am right now, and I'm basically just blocking during this because that way when the reset comes, I'll be able to deal with it. Because the one thing Skullgirls doesn't have is Touch of Death combos. Oh, darn it. Come on. Oh, darn it. Down, crouching heavy punch. Ah. One time a crouch would have saved me. Crouching move would have actually saved me in that case. I've always been worried about crouching medium punch. In that case, crouching heavy punch would have gotten me a character. Oh well. Oops. That's not what I wanted at all. And that's where blocking becomes extremely useful for punishing. Ah, darn it. Why is the register as a block? I let go of the stick. That's always annoying. I'm not sure if this is a network thing, actually. I'm starting to suspect it might be a network thing when you... When you let go of, like, the timing of letting go of crouch. That, or getting my stick tight into combo breaker makes it a lot harder to get out of crouch when I need to. That might be the case, too. I'm not sure. It's always been a problem. I'm never really sure when it's supposed to let go of the crouch input. That and the fact that despite playing this game for a year, I'm still used to the input buffer. The input buffer is super generous, but I'm just not used to the fact that it's generous. I'm used to stingy input buffers. So, having a generous input buffer is great, but okay, that was a bad idea. Having a generous input buffer is great. Oops, not what I wanted to do. At all. Well, that's a game, so I don't even know why I'm holding buttons. Feels so silly. It was a stupid crouching punch. Crouching heavy punch would have won me that match. Feels so silly. I would have been able to get the double snap and everything. Because in the corner, it says crouching heavy punch, heavy kick. Crouching heavy punch, heavy kick. I think. Maybe it's a crouching heavy punch, axe kick, but at any rate, yeah. Crouching heavy punch, axe kick. Crouching heavy punch, axe kick. Would have been... I think that's all you need to do, and then... Then you just win. Because you can get infinite combos on assists. That's the one thing. If you do a snapback and hit an assist and the point character, it's called a double snap, and you can hit the assist with a combo, and simple combos work, because you can actually do infinite combos against assists. You cannot do them against point characters. So you can actually get an assist for free. Which is really handy when your opponent throws out careless assists like that, and you can just hit them in the assist. Because the person I was fighting, they were throwing out their assists carelessly. I mean, I wasn't throwing mine out at all, which is a mistake, but they were throwing theirs out carelessly. And when they throw them out carelessly, you can take advantage of that. If you double snap. Which I wasn't. Or I tried, and I screwed up. Yay.
I'm ready to pound.
Alright, I fought this person before when I was warming up, so let's see how it goes this time. Nope. What? Why did my head fall off? When did I... great. Well, this match is over. I can't win with my head off, especially not against Big Man. Like, head off fortune against Big Man is committing suicide. But, yeah, I don't know what happened. Stupid input errors. No, I'm gonna get snapped. Why am I not getting snapped? I should be getting snapped by now. Where's the reset? Well, yeah. Down to back heavy punch. Why did I do that? What the hell did I do that? I just lost the match because I did that. Come on, get on my... Well, my only hope is to... What the heck? I did down to forward heavy punch there. Why does everything feel wonky? This entire match has felt wrong. Again, with... I don't know what I'm doing wrong here. I don't know. I have to check this video that everything felt wrong there. Like I was doing stuff and not what I wanted. Am I assist right? I don't know. What? Great. Well, now there's nobody. Yeah, I don't know what's happening in that match. I don't, like, any input errors or what? Like, I was doing heavy punch. I wasn't doing down and back heavy punch. That's not what I wanted to do. I don't know why I did that. Everything just felt wrong about that game. Okay, this is the Robo Fortune player. This is gonna be another tough one. No copycat.
So just to your health.
All right.
Okay, go.
Yeah, this. Oh. Darn it! That's where a heavy punch would work real well. Darn it. Darn it! See, that's not even like crouching attacks normally bite me in the butt. I usually don't like doing them because they never help me in a combo. Like, at the start, yes, but otherwise, I find as fallout moves, neither of my characters really have crouching attacks that help a whole lot in fall. Why did my head fall off? Again with the stupid head! Ugh. Seriously, I don't know what's going on. Why does my head keep falling off? I'm not throwing it off. I'm certainly not meaning to. Is my stick screwing up with me? Damn. It's getting really confusing. It feels like nothing's working. I just feel like I'm not able to do anything. Like, I'm doing my inputs and everything, but it's not what I expect it to be. No. Damn it. That was supposed to be down to back double kick before when I was punishing. Not nothing. Like, does this stick not work anymore? Like, I can't spend $200 for a new one, so... This is getting annoying. Like, I'm trying to do something, and it's not doing what I want it to do. Fucking execution problems. My computer's messing up. Like, I don't know. I'm okay with head-on fortune, but as soon as the head comes off, I'm dead. Yeah, this is getting really annoying. I don't know if it's, like, I know, as you can see, like, sometimes the spring is getting stuck in one direction, and that's because I got the spring tightened, but I think I got it over-tightened slightly, or something else happened, and now I can't fix it. And I don't really feel like going to Evo, which I wasn't planning on doing this year, just to talk to the guy who helped with the stick before to see if I can get it fixed, so I'm probably stuck with this for a while, because I don't know what to do. I've been suggested to buy some springs, but... I really don't have time to even go and do that. Nor do I have any screwdrivers of the right size on hand. Yeah, I'm not particularly handy. So sue me. Well, at least they fell for that one. When does it count as not crouching? I don't know, I guess that worked. That was a weird mix-up setup, but... This is a weird match, okay. At least I'm getting away with a lot of Why does that keep happening?! I'm letting go of the... Like, I'm letting go of crouch when I hit button, I think. I don't know. I don't know if it's getting stuck, or if I don't know when to hit the button, or what.
Player one pays the tab.
It's really bothering me. Like, crouching heavy punches if I don't want to do heavy punches, and throwing my head off, ever. because I never want to throw my head off. Ever. I mean, I know it sounds weird. Why am I playing Fortune? Because she has a bunch of other cool tools I like. It's just the head-on headless switch is not something I care about or really care to take advantage of. But I don't know what other character I put into a duo, and I don't know that solos are still worth playing at this point. Like, they're playable, but it's just... There are things I like about both Fuqua and Fortune. But I don't like everything about Fortune. I like pretty much everything about Fuqua, but not everything about Fortune. So if I had to go solo, I'd definitely solo Fuqua, but at the same time, I know how to... I know more combos and such with Fortune. Man, that's a throw. Damn it. Probably just play and not talk. Again with the crouching attacks I don't want to have happen. I have no idea what the buffering on that is, like how that buffering works. That really bothers me because I don't get how it works and it... Oh, great. That's just perfect. Oh, wait, I could have level 3. Darn it. Darn it. I don't want to do either. I honestly think I'm too aggressive for this game. Like, I don't understand how to defend. Especially since this game has a lot when it comes to when to push block and so forth. Ow. It's just that there's honestly no other fighting game I can, in terms of technical aspect, play. Like, there's no other fighting game that, other than, well, plus Argon PC the other day, like last week, and that's about, like, Guilty Gear XX Accent Core plus R. That got on PC last week. And that's about it, unless I want to play Street Fighter, and I don't really want to play Street Fighter. So I'm, or any of the Nether Realms games. So when it comes to Air Dashers, I'm kind of stuck. Nothing other than Skullgirls even really has much of an audience. I'm just going to go for solo Fuqua. As soon as my stick decides to cooperate with me. I don't know how well this is going to work, but whatever. Deleting first law. Ladies and gentlemen, it's your time. Ow. This is probably not going to work all that well now that I think about it. At least I can snap back to get health. Oh, come on! Yeah, I'm falling back to Guilty Gear habits. Oh, it's not even Guilty Gear habits. But yeah, my over-aggression. I want to hit them. That's all I want to do. Like, I just want to hit something. Because I just have that very direct view of things. I don't like wasting time with footsies and defense. Like, I don't know, I'm weird. I'm weird and impatient. And therefore suck at this game. Because I have no patience. It's just not something I ever had, so yeah, I'm kind of screwed. Maybe I should just go with Fortune Fuqua still, despite the head thing. And if you're wondering why I'm so pissed off, it's because it's warm here and I can't stand warmth. I get irritated when it's hot. Extremely irritated. No. Mostly because it feels harder and harder to breathe the warmer it gets. The fact that I have to wear... that my only headphone choice is big earmuff headphones probably also doesn't help because it makes me even warmer. I hate temperature. I just realized I don't like cold, I don't like warmth. I don't like temperature.
Let's see if you're up to scratch.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's
okay, I can't remember if I I know I should be doing Fiber Loop. But as you can see, I can't actually do Fiber Loop. What the? Wow, I didn't actually... Okay, that was me getting crossed up. That I was trying to do down to forward and got crossed up and did it down to back. That, I'm fine. Oops. What the heck is the... I don't even know what that is when I'm headless, to be honest. Heavy punch down to back light kick. That's what I need to do in that case. You want to get a low throw like that, because that was actually really good. I just screwed it up. And yes, I know that it's more efficient to DHC into a level 3, but at that point, I just needed the damage. I'm a bit surprised they didn't... The heck? I'm a bit surprised they didn't snap back, though. A solo snapping back will actually get life back as a result of doing a snapback. They get 2/3 of the point character, 1/3 for the assist, and they get it all back if they do a double snap. But no one's doing that. Even I'm not doing that enough. Admittedly, against a solo, it doesn't matter, but still. Against a duo or a trio especially. Actually, no, a duo especially. Because a duo, a free character is a bigger deal. A trio, you can probably get a free character just by fighting them. Like, solo versus trio, the solo can very nearly touch of death. Because they have 3 characters, so losing 1 character isn't a big deal. That's not when I wanted to push block. Ow. Okay, the mix-up should be... There we go. Again! Why does that not work? Like, I'm... Okay, that was not the best time for Fukua. Yeah, I don't know, I'm hitting the buttons, but I think I might be hitting the heavy punch after the air dash too quickly or something. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. Great. Well, at least they were leaving themselves defenseless. Okay, well, this is gonna be tough. You know, for Fukua being one of my favorite characters, or probably my favorite character, I seem to have a really hard time actually using her, other than this one trick of that combo. But hey, that trick worked! Reversal super! Why not? Well, okay, there we go. Wait, are people watching the stream? I have a tool that I'm using to try to check stream chat, but honestly, it seems pretty terrible. Like, I don't know who's actually watching the stream. Oh, Kind Hobo. I'm a bit surprised I hadn't played them up to now. Oh wait, no, I think I have. I think I actually played them earlier.
Are you ready?
Oh no, no, I didn't. No, never mind. No. No. Okay, I thought I could get out of it before that. Oh, come on. Why did I even do it? Once again, what happened? Why did the muscle memory do down a back heavy punch? Like, what other game do I know that would... No, the only other thing I can think of is Millia's Secret Garden move in Guilty Gear, which is the same muscle memory, and I would use it in that situation because, well, they're out of the way and I can just mix up. But, well, set it up and then throw it in there, but at the same time, I haven't been playing Guilty Gear that much, so I cannot possibly be that muscle memory. That's the only thing that comes to mind. Like, why else am I doing down to... Like, Fukua, I don't think, has any down-to-back punch moves. No, she doesn't have any down-to-back punch moves, so I don't know what I'm trying to do. Because down-to-back kick, which is a really handy set of moves. Yeah, I thought I knew I'd lose. I'm getting kind of distracted because I don't know what's going on with the stream or who's watching or anything. It's just... Okay, I don't think anyone's watching. Why do I even bother? I really wish replays would work and be a big thing so that I could actually cast those instead of playing. Because my play is not very good. I mean, this is basically a training diary, which no one's even reading. I don't even know why I'm doing this, honestly. Probably wasting my time. But yeah, it's like, if I could stream replays, at least that'd be something. Something interesting. Watching people who know what they're doing play. Ah, I thought I'd get past that. Not people who can barely, who can't even do their bread and butter combos. Okay, that was me getting crossed up, so whatever. I'm not salty about that one. Ah, crap. Okay, what's happening next? Great. That's actually punishable if you can do a push block guard cancel after that and get out of that. I'm dead. Oh, what? I got crossed up out of the corner. I'm not dead. Whoa, I did not expect that to work. Okay, that's not going to work. Why did they wait until it was way out there? That didn't make any sense. Just hit me right out of it. Once again, there we go. What? That's the pain in the ass about fighting Squiggly. Squiggly is really, really tiny. So easy to have her drop at your combos.
How much is my tab?
Having Squiggly drop out of your combos is a little annoying. It's not really, it's nowhere near the most aggravating thing. The most aggravating thing for me is input errors. Anything that's input errors, anything where my brain and my hands are not cooperating is the thing that pisses me off to high heaven. Like, nothing really gets me mad other than me thinking one thing and then my hands or just the controls doing something not quite what I expect. Either due to input lag, though this game basically has none, or due to network lag, though this game handles it extremely well, or due to me hitting the wrong buttons, which seems to happen all the time.
I'm ready to pounce.
So mostly me hitting the wrong buttons pisses me off. Right. That's the risky part. I can actually dash under that with Fortune, which is one of the reasons I like having Fortune on my team. Get out! Ah! Why did you jump? And yes, you can do a level 3 with only 3 if you DHC into it. What? Oh, whoops. Oh, crap. That's bad. There we go. It's like, wait, I can finish this. I can win this. Just one fireball. There we go. There's the fireball I need. All right. Let's get back to actually winning these matches. Well, shall we?
Looks like I found
interesting. My first trio that I fought today. Starting with the Makoto Fortune. Ah, whoa. They picked a good time to push block. If only I could get that stupid combo right. Clearly didn't matter, it's just, it's really bugging me. My goodness, all the Arxis references. Now we have Exert Miliophilia. Or I guess Exert Philia Rage. Let's switch over to Fuqua. Although I realize that in beta this actually doesn't deal anywhere near the amount of damage it dealt before. But hey, chip damage kill. Ah, I thought they'd... Everyone always jumps whenever you do that, so I figured that'd be another jump kit. What the heck? That wasn't a hitbox. Man, doubles a pain in the butt sometimes. Oh, nice, and they're playing Republican double. And I don't care if anyone says that's supposed to be just candidate double. It's... The original joke was Republican double, and it sounds Republican. I mean, granted, I'm Canadian, and our most... Like, just for those of you not familiar with Canadian politics, our most conservative mainstream political party is slightly to the left of the Democratic Party in the U.S. As in, slightly more liberal than the Democrats. Our most conservative political party. Like, the aptly named Conservative Party are, with a couple small exceptions in the fact that they care a little bit more about, like, some of the religious pet issues that the Republicans tend to get a lot of their base from, they're basically about the same political stripes as the Democratic Party. Okay. Note, for those of you not familiar, the dust of that attack... There we go. The dust of that attack comes on this... goes away. It's huge on the side that the car is coming from, so block in the opposite direction. Hold the stick in the opposite direction. But yeah, so from a Canadian perspective, both the Republicans and the Democrats sound like slightly more conservative than the Conservative Party, except for when you're dealing with some religious pet issues. Other than those issues, the Conservatives are basically more liberal Democrats. Yeah, you're... The U.S. is kind of scary. It's like... It's just weird. But yeah. So from a Canadian perspective, it just sounds like... Everything just sounds like... Well, might as well be Republican, because... The lines spoken are basically Republican talking points. They just call it candidate double, so it doesn't sound quite so... partisan. Oh, whoops. I could have DHC'd out of that. Oh, well. Not the best time for a reset. Right, I gotta do this when I'm expecting an assist. When I read an assist, I gotta do standing medium punch. And that's the only thing I can get out of it, which I've just aborted because I have died. Well, fortune has. Fuku is still around. No, that was... Oh, actually, that could have worked. I'm expecting them to fire missiles at some point. With three drones, that's probably the best option. Huh? Yep, there we go. Ah! Not bad. Okay. What the... Okay, well, whatever. Chip damage death again! What the? I gotta just actually throw on the ground sometimes. I'm so used to people just jumping on a reaction from that that I expect them to just jump on a reaction every time, and then I'd have to deal with that. Again with the. With that thing, with the crouching heavy punch I don't want. Like, if I was doing. Actually. Yeah, if I was doing crouching medium punch to crouching heavy punch, that's fine. Or is crouching... No, crouching medium punch, yeah. Crouching medium punch, crouching heavy punch to medium kick shadow works really well as a setup. But I'm just trying to do crouching light kick to medium to standing heavy punch to get a kill. Because that's my bread and butter combo. Wow, I have been playing Action Hank number 2 a great deal. Unless it's an array indexing operator, in which case it's the third Action Hank. But those look like parentheses, not brackets. Oops. Yeah, well, they called it that time. No, that's not gonna work. What? Well, might as well make the most of it. By motivating them to try to hit me. Oh, darn it. Oh, yeah, I guess if they push back the first one, I can go for the crouching. That would work. Should work. I think. I'm not totally sure, because I know if you do... If it's the second one they push block, it's death. Ah, oh, man, it's annoying. Well, I got that, at least. Again... Oh, actually, wait. I gotta remember to do... Okay, that's actually an opportunity for Medium Kick Shadow to shine. It occurs to me. I just hadn't had much chance to practice that, but yeah, that's actually a great time to use that. Like, just on reaction, if I screw up, just make up for it. Because actually, that's a really good setup, especially when they're... I mean, they're at combo death health, so I could probably just... Like, I get a combo and kill. So if I actually do it correctly like so, then I'm fine. What? That's throw invincible? Or I guess it's just that the throw hits... Or the beat extend hits first before the throw would. Great. Well, Fuku's not quite down yet. No, that's not gonna work. Big Band is such a pain in the ass to fight against. I never thought I'd say that, because I used to find Big Band a really easy fight, but... I don't know. Getting more and more annoying every time. I'm getting used to RoboFortune. I'm starting to realize how to dash around, at least Action Hank's RoboFortune. But that Big Band... It's probably one of Action Hank's mains. Probably switching out something for... Either adding RoboFortune or switching out something for RoboFortune. But they're clearly pretty good with Big Band. I also didn't realize Beat Extend couldn't be thrown. Yeah, that's really good to know. That's probably why they were doing Beat Extend, because at that point, I mean, there's a counter. I can Crouching Light Kick, and probably that'll work. Or if that doesn't work, Crouching Medium Kick, because that would have the same effect, but with a longer range, and thus be safer. But, yeah, like, move back a bit, Crouching Medium Kick, and then Standing Heavy Punch. And then continue pressure in the corner. That would work. So if I fight Action Hank again, and again that same situation again, I gotta remember to do Crouching Medium Kick when I'm in that corner. And not try for the throw. Because they clearly have the throw counter unlock. That's not gonna work. Oops, nope. What am I doing? There we go. That was the name of the color I'd use if I was playing Cerebella.
May include nausea.
Okay, so I think I play this. No, I haven't played this one before. It's a different solo Valentine. What the? Okay, they're not blocking. Okay, once again. Yeah, this player is just not blocking at all. I was kind of experimenting a bit because I wasn't sure. That's what I was trying to do. Finally, I got the combo off. And that's what the mix that I was talking about. I guess it helps when your opponent doesn't block. That was a little surprising. But yes, I finally got the fiber loop. Yeah. I think that's a great time to end this stream. Finally got that bloody fiber loop in a real match. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching, and have a good night, everyone. And don't forget, it's free this weekend. This game is free this weekend. If you liked what you saw or thought, I can do better than that guy. I can do so much better than them. Let me at it. Well, yeah, it's free. Go for it. It's free this weekend, and until the 8th, until Monday, it is June 8th, it is 80% off. So it's $10 for everything, including DLC. I believe that might be in Canadian dollars, but yeah. It's $10 for everything, including DLC, so everything. Everything from the base game to Eliza, because Beowulf currently is free. Anyway, once again, thanks for watching, have a good night, and I guess, yeah, play the game. Go play it.